Joining me today is New England College Professor of Political Science, Dr. Wayne Lesperance, and we're here to talk about the Republican convention that's coming up. So Wayne, the platform. In the earlier segment, you sort of talked about it sort of pushing toward the conservative wing of the Republican Party, that the Trump people are ceding that to solidify that base. Right. Talk to me a little bit more about what are the elements that we're seeing in that align with that part of the party?
Sure. Some of it will be very familiar to you. We've seen this before. For example, planks about abortion, being anti-abortion, being pro-life, the party of life, as they like to describe themselves. Things that we haven't seen, though, is an emphasis on the redefinition of family or a definition of family in a traditional sense. That many have read that would exclude, for example, gay adoption. That in some circles has taken adoption to mean those who adopt to be in a position that's different from than folks who have children naturally. So it's a kind of curious plank, but it's intended to sort of drive a wedge between Republicans, I think, and folks who are advocating for normalization of gay rights, gay marriage, gay adoption, and those sorts of things.
I mean, but
that's a big one.
But it goes against the recent rulings by this Supreme Court. I mean,
that's right, and I think it goes against what particularly a lot of younger Republicans have been saying, that you know this is not the party they want to be a part of. As the party tries to grow to live up to that big tent that Ronald Reagan talked about, this is not going in that direction. This is further narrowing the scope of folks that would be interested. There's a lot of data that says that Republicans are either agnostic or about gay marriage, gay rights, or that they are thinking, why do we draw the line there? Let's not alienate these folks who could potentially be members of our party. This is running counterstream to all of that, and I think it represents a sort of a throwback in many ways to about 20 years ago when the Republican Party took similar stances on gay rights, gay marriage.
So, I mean, and this is driven from a socially conservative wing of the party.
That's right, religious right.
And how would they take that policy and implement it into law?
Well, the first thing they have to do is get a Republican elected and hope to make some changes on the Supreme Court. That's where they see their battle taking place. They believe that with a Trump presidency, there's the potential for at least two new Supreme Court justices that could then shift the balance in their favor, and then everything is on the table, whether it's Roe v. Wade, whether it's the decision that struck down laws prohibiting gay marriage. So I think that's their strategy. I think they also believe that a socially conservative Republican president can help change culturally, can change the country. And I, you know, that remains to be seen, but that's certainly their goal.
So those are one of the other things. What are other conservative elements in that platform?
The family piece is really the big piece that's gotten a lot of the attention. And again, the abortion one we're familiar with. There's discussion about having the Bible be a piece of education in public schools. So again, another Supreme Court decision they'd like to see overturned, but bringing a greater level of comfort with religion in public institutions, K-12. That's another one. So again, that very much feels like the religious right playing a significant role, in at least in the platform formation of the platform for the convention.
And how do the other candidates downstream feel about that? Have you talked to anybody about that in sort of the governor's races? I mean, is that something that's widely endorsed or not endorsed?
No. So my experience now is mostly here in New England, and that's certainly not consistent with New England Republicans. Where New England Republicans are conservatives on more on fiscal issues, on spending, they'd like to see more emphasis there. They're certainly not going to embrace the more traditionally Southern perspective of social conservatism that we're seeing playing out in this convention platform.
Will any of that affect the local races in Vermont, New Hampshire?
Well, if the Democrats have anything to say about it, it will, because every ad you see already from Maggie Hassan against Kelly Ayotte, for example, describes how Kelly and Trump are absolutely connected at the hip, that she is Trump's person, she's from Trump's party. And that's going to be something that you're going to find Republicans having to explain who are running in New England.
And is she connected at the hip with Trump?
Absolutely not. I mean, Kelly has all but rejected him, and she won't endorse him. He's the nominee of her party, but but she won't endorse him. So I think it tells you that there's not a lot of love lost there. You remember Kelly's closest with in the Senate with John McCain and Lindsey Graham,
and neither one of those guys are Trump supporters.
They're not speaking at the convention. They won't have anything to do with it. There's a lot of incongruence in the Republican Party these days, and largely driven by Trump's candidacy.
All right. Well, we're out of time in this segment. When we return, we're going to continue our conversation and focusing on some of these dissenting views. So please stay with us.